Dear brothers and sisters, we find that many people seem to be very happy when things are going their way. And when something happens which they don't like, they get very upset and start to complain. What is very interesting is that they might complain to someone who is trying to help them. Many times we find that as life goes on, we get programmed in a manner in which we think that everyone else is trying to get the better of us. As the child grows and as the child wants either some toys, or a child wants to be out late. So when the parents say no to what the child feels should be good for the child gets very upset. And the child feels as if the parents are always there to say no. When we look at the life of the spouses, we find that one partner is always in a mode in which if everything doesn't happen the way that partner wants, they feel as if the other partner is out to get them or is there to create difficulties for them. The same thing happens when you go to work. Many of us feel that as we work hard, maybe there are others in our work environment who take the benefit of what we are doing. And so we just get programmed as if everyone else out there is out to get us and that we are the victims. I'd like to relate a very interesting story coming from the past. This story is about an emperor. An emperor who was very good to the people in his kingdom. This emperor would do very good things for all the people living in the kingdom. And he also hired many good, faithful people to help in the kingdom. He would take care of everyone whose needs he thought needed to be met. And so everyone really loved him. They liked him a lot because he was very, very helpful. And as the activities in the kingdom were going on, things seemed to be pretty well for everyone living in the kingdom. As there were many people to help the emperor, with time, seemed to be very happy with one of the employees. This employee was very caring, was very faithful, was appreciative of everything that happened with him, and the king started to like him a lot. Now, as the king or the emperor liked this employee a lot, there were others who started to notice that. And as generally happens, they started to get jealous of the attention that the emperor would give to this employee. And so they banded together and they started to backbite this employee and started to say things like, oh, he's not loyal to you, emperor, and he is one way and he is in another way in front of you, and started to say things like that. But the emperor knew better, so he thought of a way to let all the other people working in that kingdom realize why the emperor liked this employee the most. So he invited all the employees in the kingdom to come for a grand dinner. And so in this big hall in the palace, a grand dinner was set up. And there were tables after tables on which all the employees were sitting. And there was lavish food which had been set up. And there was a riser on which the emperor sat. And then as the emperor wanted to start this dinner for everyone, he invited this employee that he liked the most to come to this dais or the riser which was set up for the emperor. And there were a lot of dishes set up on the table. So the emperor took a spoon and opened up one of the dishes, a vegetable dish, and he took a spoonful and he fed this employee. And the employee ate it and said, "Thank you for your kindness, O my emperor," and gave him a big smile. And then the emperor took the same spoon and went to the same dish and gave him another spoonful. And he ate it and he thanked the emperor again. And the emperor kept on doing this, one spoon after another, for this one dish. And every time the employee would be smiling and would compliment the king for giving him that meal to eat. And then a last spoonful was left. And so instead of giving the spoonful to the employee, the king put that spoon in his own mouth. And as soon as he bit into the food, he said, "Yuck, this is so bitter." And then he turned to this employee and the emperor said, "You know, this dish is so bitter and I've been giving you spoon after spoon, so why didn't you tell me that this was bitter?" The employee smiled and he said, "Oh my emperor, in all these years, you've been giving me so much sweetness. You've been giving me so much love. You've been taking care of all my needs. And there's been so much love and sweetness coming from you. So this one moment of bitterness was not meaningful for me to be able to say anything to you." And then the king make an announcement to everyone else. He said, "All of you have been talking about him to me, and I want to tell you why I like him the most. It's because he's loyal, because he's appreciative of whatever happens to him, whether it is good for him or it is not good for him." And it is then that all the employees realize how much goodness they were receiving for the king, and not to worry about what someone else were receiving, or to think that they were not getting enough or someone else was getting more. And when we look at our lives, we also many times lead our lives just like all of these other employees of the king was living. You know, we need to realize that along with the sunny days, there are going to be rainy days. Along with the brightness, there is bound to be some darkness. Along with the roses, there are bound to be some thorns. And we need to deal with them all in the same manner. We can't be happy when the sun is out and feel very sad when it's raining. We can't be happy when there's light outside and be sad when it's dark. There's bound to be the day, there's bound to be the night. Ups and downs of life are a part of our existence. And we need to be appreciative of what is happening in our life. Saints and mystics realize that. And they exhort us to live under the principle of sweet as I will. To focus on our blessings and not on what we think we need. If we live our life by focusing on our blessings, we'll find that there are thousands and thousands of blessings that we can count. We have food on the table, we can support our families, we are taking care of many, many needs of those we love. And those are all very good things in our life. And so when one thing goes wrong, let's say in the life of a child, if the child gets 99 toys that it wants and doesn't get one, there's no reason to get upset. If between spouses, most things are all well, but there are few discrepancies here and there, it's nothing to be upset about. If at work, most things are working out well, but a few things don't work well, then that's a part of life. We need to deal with it. We should not always keep on feeling that whatever we want is what should pan out in our life. Because we don't know enough of what is good for us. Sant Rajinder Singh Maharaj, who wrote a lot about our life and how it should be lived, he says in one of his verses, "Nahi janta ki main kya tujhse mangu, jo mere liye hai bhala chahta hu." So Sant Rajinder Singh Maharaj is praying to God, "Oh God, I don't know what to ask of you because my knowledge is limited. I only know about what has happened to me in this lifetime. And that too, I might have forgotten many things and might not be aware of everything that happened to me. But you, O Lord, you know my past, you know my present, and you know my future, and you know what would be good for me. So please give me what you think is good." And that's the kind of life that we need to lead. Not my will, but thy will be done. Not what we think is good for us, because we are very limited in what we know. We could have gone to school, we could have got a bachelor's degree, a master's degree, a PhD. We could be an expert in whatever field we've trained ourselves. But our knowledge is still very limited. There is so much more that happens that we are aware of. And as it is, none of us is aware of what happens to us previous to this lifetime. And we definitely don't know what is going to happen to us as we physically die. But the Creator, who brought all creation to being, the Creator was there in the beginning of creation. So the Creator is aware of everything that has happened with us, everything that's happening with us, and everything that will happen with us. And so when we leave it up to God to have in our life that what is good in God's will, then our life would be lived very smoothly, very peacefully, and very lovingly. So we need to be appreciative of what we have rather than complain about one thing or another. Let us focus on what is good in our life. Let us focus on what is correct in our life. There'll be times when we'll be physically healthy. There'll be times when we'll be physically ill. Let's not complain when we're not physically well, because we did not appreciate when we were okay. Let's appreciate the times that we are well. And if you look at your own lives, the percentage of time that one is ill is much, much smaller than the percentage of time when we are well. And so let's look at the positivity in our lives. And those who live in that manner are the ones who lead the life in the best possible of manners. Any negativity puts us in turmoil. And when we are in turmoil, we are not stilled. And when we are not stilled, we can't focus on who we truly are. We all have a purpose in life, that is to know ourselves and to know God. And to know ourselves, we need to be stilled in the body and in the mind. So any time there is turmoil in our life, when there's negativity in our life, when we are complaining, those are times when we're not stilled. And those are the times we need to get away from. Let us just remember that there are so many good things that are happening to each and every one of us. Let us focus on what is good in our life, and we will be on a journey back to our true home. So let us all meditate for a few minutes. Please sit as comfortably as you can. Close your eyes very gently, just like you close them when you go to sleep. Your eyeball should be straight, focus 8 or 10 inches in front of you. And as you close your eyes, those of you who have been initiated in the mysteries of the beyond, please do your simran. Those of you who are new here, please repeat any name of God that you feel comfortable with. The repetition should be done mentally and not out loud. I pray to God Almighty and to the three great spiritual masters of the past century, Hazur Baba Savan Singh Ji Maharaj, Param Sant Kripal Singh Ji Maharaj, Dayal Purush Sant Darshan Singh Ji Maharaj, to help each and every one of us connect with the divine power within and to experience the divine light in its effulgence. We'll be sitting for a few minutes. I'll be getting you out of this meditative state at that time, and my best wishes are with each and every one of you. Please leave off, Chhod dijiye ji.